Custom GPT is a system that allows you to shape your own AI assistant through personalized instructions. While the normal ChatGPT provides general information, a custom GPT operates entirely based on your rules. You define specific tasks for it, and each time you ask a question, it responds according to those predefined instructions. In other words, you are no longer talking to a generic chatbot, but to a personal assistant built specifically for you. In this video, I will demonstrate an example using stock photography, but you can use this knowledge to create a completely different assistant tailored to your own needs. In the world of stock images, it is difficult to stand out without clear titles, descriptions, and well-optimized keywords. The key to making your photos noticeable among hundreds of others lies in preparing accurate metadata. The custom ChatGPT we will create will help us exactly with that. The best part is that instead of repeating the same tasks over and over, you can define them once and get consistent results every time. The real value here is saving time and having an assistant that fully understands your preferences. For example, your GPT can always generate exactly 48 keywords, adjust the title according to the image, and optimize the description to around 200 characters. You can also add your personal style to this process. You decide how your photos are described, which words are used, and what format becomes the standard. The result is not just an automated output, but a personalized assistant that reflects your perspective. Let's begin creating our custom GPT. First, go to the ChatGPT website and sign in with your account. It is important to note that this feature is available only for paid users. If you don't see the GPT section in the left menu, you are probably using a free version. After signing in, click the GPT section on the left. You will see examples of ready-made GPTs. Click on Explore. Here you can view and study previously created and shared custom GPTs. They can also be a source of inspiration. When you open this page, you will see a Create button in the top right corner. Click it and the custom GPT creation screen will open. There are two options, Create and Configure. If the Create tab is active, you can build a GPT through conversation. However, I prefer to use the Configure tab and fill out the form manually. Let's continue with the stock photography example. We will enter a prompt related to metadata generation for stock photos. This is a sensitive topic with specific rules, so manual setup will provide more reliable results. During manual setup, it is important to name your GPT. If you have multiple custom GPTs, this will help you avoid confusion. For this project, let's name it Stock Metadata Generator. Next, move on to the description and instruction fields. What you write here defines what the AI will do, how it will behave, and which standards it will follow. The rules should be written clearly. For example, if you want the title or description to be limited to 200 characters, you should specify it here so you won't have to manually shorten the text later. Most stock sites allow up to 50 tags, and exceeding that number could cause issues. To truly save time, you should define these limits in detail. For each image, I want the assistant to generate three things: title, caption, and keyword. If it provides these correctly, it means the assistant is working properly. I'll write these prompts in English. The title should clearly describe the image. If the text box feels small, click the icon on the side to expand it. Sometimes I upload 3D render images. In such cases, I want it to recognize that and automatically add 3D rendering at the beginning of the title. Also, many stock websites reject captions longer than 200 characters, so I'll set that as a limit. Stock sites generally allow up to 50 keywords, but I'll set my assistant to generate 48. I don't want multi-keyword, like digital file, only single word once. However, if the image is a 3D render, it should include 3D rendering among the keywords. All others should remain single words. There should be no repeated or merged words. Once this part is done, you can adjust it according to your own needs. Then click Close. One of the great features of custom GPTs is that you are not limited to written instructions. You can also upload additional information. By clicking Upload Files, you can add documents from your computer to make your assistant smarter and more capable. Normally, as you know, GPT uses a vast amount of internet knowledge. However, when you upload your own examples, its focus becomes narrower and the answers it provides become more consistent with your documents. You can choose whichever model you prefer. I will leave it as non-recommended here because what we are doing doesn't depend much on the model. Any model can handle this task quite well. Next, we see a section called Capabilities. In this part, you can individually enable or disable options like code execution, web browsing, and image generation. You can adjust these according to your needs. For example, the code execution feature is useful for those who need to perform calculations or process data. In our case, we are not doing any kind of data processing or calculation, so we don't need to turn this on. The web browsing feature allows GPT to fetch up-to-date information from the internet. This can be helpful for fast-changing topics, but since our stock photography instructions are already defined, we don't need it here. So I will leave it off. You can modify these settings according to your own use case. Similarly, for image generation, we don't expect this assistant to produce images, so that feature can also remain disabled. We have entered the instructions and adjusted the capabilities. The next step is to publish it. But before that, it is important to test. For now, it's still in draft mode. To save it, you would normally click the Create button, but before doing that, we will test it using the Preview mode. Let's see if it produces the kind of results we want. I'll take one of my images, a blue folder, and paste it here. Let's check whether it analyzes the image and gives us the correct metadata as expected. After clicking Submit, it uploads the image and generates a title. Blue digital folder, icon, isolated on white background, that's a nice title. The caption is also well written and suitable for stock photos. It even recognized that this is a 3D render and added the phrase 3D rendering off, just as we specified earlier in the caption instructions. Sometimes it may not detect this automatically. In that case, you can simply tell it this is a 3D image and it will rewrite the output accordingly. Then we have the keyword section. I won't count all 48 keywords now, but since it recognized the image as a 3D render, it included 3D rendering among them. All the other keywords are single words and directly related to the image, which is great. Finding, writing, and organizing all of this manually would be very time-consuming, but now it's much easier. In other words, we are saving time while maintaining quality. If the results look good and the assistant is responding as you expect, the next step is to click Create to finalize it. Here, you will see some access options. You can keep it private by selecting Only Me, or you can generate a shareable link if you want others to use it. You can also publish it to the GPT store if you would like. I'll keep mine private, so I will click Save. Once saved, you can click View GPT to open it directly. If you want to make changes later, go to Edit GPT. Earlier, I forgot to add an image, so I'll click the plus icon. You can upload your image or use DALL-E to generate one automatically. I'll click DALL-E and ask it to create an image for me. It generated a visual titled Stock Metadata Generator. If you don't like the result, you can click Use DALL-E again to produce another image. I think the previous one looked better, but let's keep this for now. Then click Update. As mentioned, you can also upload your own custom image if you prefer. After updating, click View GPT to open its page. If it doesn't appear, you will find it listed under the GPT section on the left side. Now let's do one more test. I will upload another sample image and ask the assistant to generate metadata according to the instructions. Reviewing the output, I can see that it is working quite well. It is important to test how your written instructions perform in practice. If your instructions are clear, the results will be consistent. But if the GPT doesn't respond exactly as you expect, that usually means something in your instructions is missing or unclear. Sometimes being a bit stricter helps the model learn to follow your standards every time. That's it for this video. In this tutorial, we have seen how to create and test a custom GPT. I hope you found it helpful. See you in the next video.